Okay, and now we have on the bed with her. Introduce, well, Nicole, you go ahead, introduce him.
Okay, so this is one of my very good friends, one of my besties.
Well, I'm like your bestie.
Okay,
bitch.
So this is my bestie on the East Coast. This is Angelo Garcia.
What's up?
Oh, you have an East Coast best friend and a West Coast best friend.
Yes.
Okay.
Doesn't everybody?
Yes. Angelo Garcia, not a lot of people know. There's some people know who he is. But basically, if you remember the boy band Menudo with Ricky Martin.
From Puerto Rico.
He was actually in the band. He was little Angelo. And now he is all big and grown up. He's not little Angelo anymore.
A big Angelo.
Yeah, he's big Angelo.
How did you guys meet?
I think we met... We met through Eric Rhodes, God rest him.
We met through a porn star that committed suicide or something like that.
So, would you do porn? Have you done porn?
No.
What's your views on porn?
My views on porn is that if I don't make it successfully as an actress or a singer, I probably will go to porn.
Okay.
I have a lot of respect for porn stars.
I'll probably go to browsers.
But that last...
I'll go full on female porn, like straight porn. But,
okay.
It takes a lot of balls to be a porn star.
But I don't think that's going to happen.
Okay. That's last resort.
That's my last resort, but I don't think that's going to happen. I think I'm going to
And there's
it.
A need for it. Come on. I mean, it serves a very imperative purpose in life.
Did you guys instantly connect when y'all met?
Yes. Because we're both pop stars, so it's like when he's singing, and it just inspired me that what he's doing and what he did in the past, I was like, oh my God, that's everything I wanted to do, because I wanted to do the girl group Secret Girls, and he was already in a guy group, so it's kind of like, it was kind of inspiring to me.
What? Well, let me ask you a question. I don't know if you would answer, but did you know Ricky was gay back then?
You know what? When I got in the boy band, I was 11. And he was 17.
Okay.
Which, as a result, 11 and 17 is a huge age gap versus...
Totally.
Versus
you don't even know who you are
or
what's somebody else. Right.
So at that age, I was more interested in video games and just being a kid. And he was already finding his sexuality. So for me, he was just a normal kid. You know what I mean? And I really didn't realize that he was gay until I was 14.
Okay. Are you still friends with him?
Of course. He's my brother.
What about performing with him now? Would you perform with him now?
I would never turn down the opportunity to perform anywhere. Okay. I love performing. It's part of who I am.
What kind of music do you have?
I do electro dance. It's my own sound, but if I had to describe it or compare it to anything, it would be what Gaga or Rihanna would have done if they would have been born a man.
Are those two people that you like and inspire you?
Absolutely. They inspire me. They're edgy. They're outspoken. They're very much congruent to the type of artist that I am. I feel that the male artists in the pop world have not brought it for a really long time. I feel that the women have totally colonized and monopolized the industry as far as pop music is concerned. And it's time to take that crown back and, you know, share it with the boys.
Nicole, what do you feel about Miley Cyrus?
Miley? Yeah. I love Miley.
We love Miley, yeah. Miley's everything.
Have you guys performed already? Would y'all perform again? Would y'all perform again?
Yeah, we're working on a track. We have a lot of tracks that we've been flirting with.
Yeah.
One of them called Undressy Right Now, which is one that we're exploring that we may possibly record. But I was also talking about a track that I wanted to do the rap on.
Oh, yeah.
So, yeah, we'll eventually
do
something.
You're not a rapper.
Now this is what I want to go into with you.
Yeah.
I've seen a lot of your YouTube shows. Actually, Sanaa was the one to put me on some because I always thought they were entertaining. I love your relationship with your cats. I don't like cats, but to me, your relationship with the cats is so real. To me, you already have a mini reality show.
Yeah, totally.
Sometimes you play around, you do a little skit, you do little things. What?
Her aunt, have you seen her aunt?
Mm-mm.
My aunt.
Your crazy aunt.
Oh my God.
Oh yeah,
you're my man.
Oh my God.
You're very close with your family, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. What kind of relationship, like your mother, how is that?
Well, kind of like it's a roller coaster.
Okay.
Because me and my mother, we get along, we fight, and then it's like...
Well, let's, he knows, it's dysfunctional.
Yeah. Right now, we're fighting.
Dysfunction, okay. Junction.
How is that for you?
It's hard, I mean, because it's like...
Well, had the fighting ever had to do with you being trans?
No.
Has that ever been an issue?
She wasn't supportive in the beginning, but she supported me after.
Okay.
And now, you know, she just, something she did pissed me off, and we had a fight on Thanksgiving, and I was thrown out the house.
But they're going to fix it.
The last time that I was thrown out the house was when I was 17 years old.
Okay.
So for my stepfather to, like, say, Nicole, you got to leave, that was just, you know, to me, it was just, like, it brought back memories. So
gotcha.
we had a talk a week ago, and I, you know, we had a little talk, and it's just left as this right now. It's not like nobody apologized. She didn't apologize because she believes I owe her an apology, and I believe
that's
she owes
me an
apology.
Do you feel like that's sometimes good as far as, like, when it goes, when you go through a situation with somebody, and, like, you start speaking again, and y'all don't talk about it? Do you think that's good? Because I have had instances with people where, and then later on, it comes back out and it's even bigger than before because maybe it wasn't squashed.
Yeah. Well, we talked about it, but I don't know. It's like...
You're not apologizing.
Which is very... No, because I felt like I did nothing wrong.
Well, but, you know what,
I mean,
baby?
It's just... It's going to be, like, at that level where, you know, I feel like I'm 17 all over again.
Mm-hmm. Time heals all wounds.
Yeah. Most definitely do. Do you have brothers and sisters?
Yeah, I have two little brothers. Well, they're not little. They're, like, college. Yeah.
How's your relationship with them?
Great.
So... Nicole,
yeah.
What is some advice that honestly, on this camera, on this show, before we close out, that you would give to girls that are coming into this life, that are thinking about this life, that are in this life? What would you tell them?
I would tell them, never give up on your dreams. You can be better than just an escort or a prostitute. Never set your goals to at a low, because you can always do much more than anything you could ever imagine as long as you put your mind to it. Don't ever take no for an answer. And, you know, when something feels down and out, don't ever feel like it's like the end of the world. Like, I might go through my little spurts of trying to commit suicide or saying I'm gonna kill myself but honestly, I go through it and then I get over it because I know, like, I have so much to offer. So don't ever think like it's the end of the world, because you can still go on and become somebody.
Do you have any regrets?
I have no regrets.
None?
Never have regrets.
Do you think that all, like I always said I had no regrets, but then I do have some regrets. I realize people I may wish I never dated, maybe, or
yeah.
Do you feel like there's anything that you wish that maybe you didn't deal with or didn't have to encounter, or do you feel like everything happened for a reason?
Well, I definitely do have some regrets. So yeah, I do have regrets. I have regrets dating certain people. I have regrets getting certain surgeries with a certain doctor.
Oh, and touching back on that, if you could refer anyone to somewhere where to go, where would a person go to find out what's the best surgeon for
the
something?
Best, well, basically,
for example, vaginas. Consult.
Okay, for
I heard that Thailand is the best.
No, absolutely.
Colorado.
One of the best surgeries for SRS is Dr. Brassard in Montreal, which I went to Montreal, Canada, and did it with Dr. Menard, which trained Dr. Brassard. Then there's Dr. Meltzer.
Mm-hmm.
He does very pretty vaginas. And that's pretty much it that I've seen that's been really pretty. Dr. Okay. Reed in Miami for revision.
Mm-hmm.
He did my revision. He did a really good job. Other than that, everyone else that
I've
seen.
What about silicone removal?
Silicone removal.
That you can say to, because you know there's a lot of girls that you and I both know that have gone to these doctors of recent years. I've heard different doctors of before that was giving genuine silicone. What about these newer doctors that are serving the girls?
Horrible.
Right. Who do you know anyone that they can go to for removal that could help them, or maybe?
The ones that I mean, honestly, I'm a beauty consultant for a doctor in Beverly Hills. His mm-hmm. name is Dr. Harrison Lee.
Okay.
And he has actually been making a lot of the girls from pretty to drop dead gorgeous. Like, he takes girls and just molds them to looking like Maxim models. So he's one of, and he does silicone removal.
Mm-hmm.
So if you,
I heard that's a really grueling process. But what do you know?
It's a grueling process because when you're going to try to take silicone out of your body, it's not all coming out of you. It's it's attached to your bone, attached to your muscles, attached to your skin and your tissues, and it's very hard because when you're taking out silicone, you're taking out your own tissue.
Right, it's crazy.
But I've done
basically
it on my leg, and my leg is really like, it's calcified to where it's like, it's really hard, you know, so it's something I deal with, and I do a lot of exercising and a lot of dancing, and that's what keeps it mobile, but if it didn't, I'd probably be walking with a stiff leg.
Wow.
Yeah.
What would you say, who can the girls go to now for silicone? Should they get silicone now? Honestly.
Oh, my God.
And I know when you say my God, it's being real, because
you
don't want to tell a girl to go somewhere, but you also know how it is, because there's so many.
The one that I see, the only two people for silicone nowadays is Joanne or it's Lisa Marie in Connecticut. Those are the only two people. And Lisa Marie got trained by Joanne. So, I mean, those are the only two people. Other than that, I've never heard of them. I don't know who they are. So don't ask me about this one and that one. Don't hit me up on Facebook and ask me for somebody. Oh, how's this talking? Joanne or Lisa Marie.
Legendary Joanne.
Exactly. That is it. Because if you go to Molina or this one or that one or that one, you'll gag as you have a table in your leg in like 10 years from now. You know? A marble table.
I mean, it sounds crazy, but it's just being real, to be honest with you.
I'm being serious.
What about implants?
like hip implants?
No, breast implants or any... and SFS. What about
FFS? FFS and implant surgeries in general, Dr. Harrison Lee is one of the best.
Okay.
Yeah.
Expensive, though.
Yeah, he is very pricey. He has two offices, one in New York, one in LA. So if you are in New York, if you call the office and you say Exotica and you ask for Susan, she will actually book you with a free consultation.
Mm.
And it's also a discounted rate for your surgery. So that's the little discount that I give you.
A little tip you're giving them.
Yeah. So use Exotica, call them up, and they will they'll help.
Well, they can never say you didn't help them out. So let them know now, every way they can contact you, buy your music, check you out. Start with that.
Well, I am still trying to set up my website. So it's Nikki-, that little slash in the middle, Exotica with a K, Exotika.com. I'm working on that right now. But then I have my Facebook, which is NikkiExoticaOfficial.com. And then I have my Facebook page, facebook.com/NikkiExotica, and Twitter, everything is all NikkiExotica.
Everything. Okay. Anything else you got coming on YouTube? Because you haven't been on active on YouTube as you used to be.
I haven't been active. I've been busy.
Okay.
I've been actually, you know, I was moving around, so I went from New York, I went from Jersey, and I moved across to Los Angeles. And right now I'm in the process of moving out of my other place to moving into a bigger apartment in May, because I want a bigger apartment because I'm spoiled. So
no more living in New York for you?
No, I'm done.
You're done?
I kind of done. Just finished wrapping up a reality show, which is going to air at the end of summer, early fall.
Okay.
And the show is called Botched. It's on E! Channel. And it's going to be amazing.
A Kiki.
It's going to be about... It's almost like a Dr. 90210 type of skit, but instead of Dr. 90210, it's actually the lives of the patients. So.
And you, your bestie, how can they contact you and listen to your music? Because I think people are going to be intrigued by just how you guys look next to each other.
You can contact me, facebook.com/AngeloGarciaCantante, C-A-N-T-A-N-T-E, I think. Anyway, just enter Angelo Garcia on the Facebook search, and I'm the first tee to pop up. So,
oh, Nicole, I forgot, so many questions. Nicole, you can go all day with you. Fitness, like what kind of fitness are you into? Like besides dancing, do you work out and stuff?
Yeah, I do.
Yes, we work out together
dancing,
all the time.
It's dancing, lots of dancing.
Pilates.
Yeah, lots of dancing.
Yoga.
And lots of dancing. I'm speaking. Lots of dancing and lots of sex. And sex and you burn a lot of calories.
What's the best sex? What do you consider good sex or the best sex?
I don't know. What do you consider good sex?
You mentioned well like endowed
passion,
before.
Passionate. Right? It needs to be passionate.
I mean, yeah, but that doesn't burn the calories.
Sweaty, salty.
When you said well endowed, what is well endowed to you?
Like 13 inches.
Oh my god.
I'm just kidding. No, like 8. Yeah.
8 plus.
All right. Well, thank you guys so much.
I have one more.
You want more?
Yeah, I have one more. Okay. One more question. You gotta ask me.
One more question. You want me to ask you?
One more question. You gotta ask me.
It is.
Any other projects coming up?
Hello? Oh, of course. Yeah. I forgot. Tell me everything you have coming up.
Secret Girls. I didn't talk about.
Gentlemen. Yeah, hello.
What's everything you have coming up?
Okay, so new projects coming up. Oh, basically, nice. I am working on hopefully getting my own spin-off show after this series airs. So
When is the date on that?
End of summer, early fall.
Okay, but you will be in contact. You'll be telling me like when
to
promote
that. Yeah, I'll keep in touch with you. But E! Channel really loves me. I made an impact on the 8 episodes. I'm like one that they're really keeping their eye out on. So it's great.
Did you reach out to them or they stumbled upon you?
No, they stumbled upon me.
Okay.
So I'm really excited on that. They did my boobs on the TV show, and I got new boobs, and I did my, I performed my new single, All Lines Up, on my big reveal. So you guys are going to see it when it airs on E! So I'm really excited. So E! Channel's like thinking about hopefully giving me my own show, and my own show would be Secret Girls, which is the girl band that I've been trying to form and put together. Mm-hmm. So I'm really excited about that.
Is the spinoff contingent on how well that does when it is?
Correct.
Okay.
Yes.
So it's important that the community, everyone, just watch you and just tune in.
Yeah,
okay.
It's going to be good. And I just got an email for a movie role.
Okay.
For Gem and the Holograms.
You know what's crazy?
Yeah.
I can see you doing something like that.
So,
are you going to be a hologram or a misfit?
A misfit. Pizzazz.
Okay. I'm going after the role of Pizzazz because she's exotic. Mm. She's sexy. They're looking for girls that can sing, dance, act, which is me. And I got the crazy pointy nails. That's not a hologram.
And she's a bitch.
When is the audition?
It's actually, I have to send in my reel by April 2nd.
Are you nervous?
No.
You're not?
I got my whole outfit. Like, I'm going to look like Pizzazz. It's crazy. I got
green hair and everything?
Yeah.
Okay, so you're going all out as usual.
Going all out. Like, you know how I bring Halloween?
Yes.
I'm going to bring a misfit. You're going to see me.
Have you been researching the cartoon and stuff?
I have. That was my favorite when I was little, was Gem and Holograms. That was my favorite cartoon. So I know a lot about it.
I think it's kind of strange nostalgia how they do a lot of the 80s stuff. They're bringing it back now.
Yeah. They want a more modernized version of the misfits. So I'm have to modernize her. It's not going to be like the 80s. It's going to be now.
2014 and beyond.
Right.
And what else you got coming up?
My new single is going to be, All Lined Up is going to be out on iTunes in June.
Okay.
So that could be out for download before the TV show airs. Mm. And I will be shooting a music video for that song. So I'm really excited. I have a lot of great things
from
coming
New York to London town.
When is the time they can expect you at a ball?
Oh, God.
You say it's so disgruntled.
Because
so
I don't really see balls anymore. I really don't. I mean, honestly,
does it kind of bother you too that you don't?
If it's a cash prize, I'll come.
I forgot to ask you this. Sex siren. What is your definition of sex siren?
What my definition of sex siren is would be.
Do you have to be naked? Do you have to have your clothes off for sex siren?
No. You can be sexy. But
you definitely have to show skin.
You can have a cat suit on, and you can still be sexy. Mm. As long as you got that body.
I told you to shut it off.
She's taking a call, guys. Go ahead.
My God.
What is it to you?
Sex iron is a form and expression of your body. What was that?
What the hell?
It's just an expression of how you express yourself through your body and stuff, you know. And I mean, sex iron is cute. I mean, I like walking sex iron, but I'm kind of getting over it.
Who were some of your sex iron peers that you considered sexy?
I mean, Sanaya, of course, was like, you know, the epitome of sex iron. At that time, I looked up to. I don't know anybody else, really.
Any of these girls now?
No. Not over me.
How did you feel about your latex? And you walked the latex ball like 2 years ago, Red Riding Hood. How did you feel about that night?
Oh, so shady. We all know who had it that night. Come on now. Like, every, you know, I had gotten into it with some haters on Facebook, and they were like, oh yeah, bitch, you, like, you don't even have it anymore, blah, 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 blah. Like, I was like, you got nerves. We all know who's the winner that night. Like, I don't understand how, who won over me, but I was just like, okay. You know, I'm not gonna fight over a stupid plastic trophy. It's not that serious.
And so just to close out, Nikki Exotica, thank you so much. You're such a sweetheart. Very real. I'm glad because, you know, I've been wanting to do this for a while and you're just very... Oh, and just to let you guys know, I asked her beforehand, so they know if anything, and you said talk about anything.
Talk about anything.
You know how some people, you know, they go with the thing. That's why I changed it, because, you know, some things you may not want to read. She said anything. Just to let you guys know, this is very real in her part.
It's raw.
Practice safe sex, guys, no matter what. Raw and talking, not raw and sex. Have a great day.
Bye.
Yeah. Back.